Yeah.
Yo, Jay, turn me up in the headphones.
Before Skinny from the Nine dropped viral monster tracks like Love Blast, Jump Out That, 5 Days, Space, and Back When I Was Broke.
I've been grinding for a long time, all by myself. I ain't never really have no major help, no major budgets, no label. I'm independent.
Before Skinny from the Nine had a massive social media fan base with 32.8 thousand followers on Twitter, 150,000 subs on YouTube, and 608,000 followers on Instagram at the time of this recording. Before Skinny from the Nine attracted the attention of record labels all over the country, signing a $5 million deal with LA Reid's new label, Hitco Entertainment, as well as reportedly joining Treyway. Skinny from the Nine is a hip-hop artist known for giving you some of 2018's biggest online bangers. Hailing from the small town of Somerville, New Jersey, the rapper overcame a childhood literally from the bowels of hell to become one of the genre's most promising acts. His mother and stepfather, they lived a life on the other side of the law, dragging their army of kids with them all over the country. Now Skinny, he was basically left to raise his younger siblings before ending up in child services. And well, this led him to getting hooked on one particular track by Eminem. He poured his heart and soul into his lyricism, and he gets some inspiration and motivation from other rap stars, including Fetty Wap and ASAP Rocky. Now, I recently went on a trip to LA, and I actually paid a visit to Skinny's label Hitco, and there they played for me some of his unreleased work. And trust me, this kid, he's gonna do some big things. What's going on, guys? It's your boy Michael McCrudden, documenting the life and career of Skinny from the Nine, here for you, of course, and before they're famous. Now, we've done profiles on several other up-and-coming rappers, including Lil Nar, Slim Reese, Dave East, and Bazzy. Be sure to check those out. A big thanks goes out to Skinny for helping answer our questions so we can get this video made. Helps a lot. Let us know any other artists or celeb you want us to document in the future in the comments down below. This video was brought to you by our good friends over at Candy Pens. Finally, let's get into Skinny from the Nine. Hey, be sure to subscribe and hit that bell. Boom!
Hey yo, shout out to homie Don back at Gold Gods, you know what I'm saying? I shot my 5 Days music video over there, came back, they showed hella love. I'm saying they hooked it up for
Skinny from the Nine was born David Alex Villegas on December 19th, 1995, in Hialeah, Florida. Now, that's a city in Miami's Dade County area. He is of Puerto Rican, Colombian, and Dominican descent. Skinny's life was troubled from the get-go. His father went to jail when the rapper was only young. His mother remarried and had 6 other kids with Skinny's stepdad. These children were Joshua, Alex, Julia, Nicholas, Christopher, and Samantha. His mother and stepdad, they were also involved in nefarious activities, such as scamming credit cards and identity theft. Now, as a result, the family was constantly on the run, moving from state to state. Looking back on his childhood, Skinny never lived in one place for more than a year. Commenting on his mom's criminal life, well, he revealed that he couldn't refer to her by her real name because it would risk blowing her cover. That's a monster sh- Now, Skinny described being shy and timid as a boy, and he would often play video games. He'd watch anime, and he'd read comic books while listening to hip-hop. Now, out of all the rappers he admired, well, Skinny had a particular attachment to Eminem, whose music helped him cope with his family's troubled affairs. He stated, "I remember the first time I heard Cleaning Out My Closet. It was incredible. I felt like we were going through the same struggle, and it was crazy how much I could relate to his experiences." M was Skinny's motivation to begin writing down some lyrics. The unfortunate truth was that Skinny's home life, it was falling apart. By the time he was 12, Skinny and the family, they had moved all over the country. They had lived in Florida, New York, Mississippi, the Carolinas, Georgia, Pennsylvania, and even Sin City. We're talking Nevada. Now his stepfather, he got sent to the slammer, and the kids, well, they were seeing less and less of mom around the house. Arriving in Union City, New Jersey, well, Skinny described times when his mother would leave the kids alone for weeks on end. With he and his brother Josh, well, they were being tasked with taking care of the younger ones. Now other times, his mom, she would leave the kids with random people she knew, many of whom were abusive. Now Skinny said that one guardian they had, he would lock his younger brother and sisters in his basement. And when the kids would scream for help, well, Skinny would be threatened not to open the door. The kids had many experiences being left on their own. Arriving home from school one day, well, Skinny described seeing their belongings sitting outside their apartment door. They had been evicted. He also once got into a scuffle over baseball cards and got knocked to the ground. He got back up on his feet and sent the kid running the other way. Now, eventually, one of his younger siblings phoned Child Services. Workers from the organization, they showed up to the residence and they took them all away. Now, unfortunately, the siblings, they were all separated by the state, with Skinny and his brother Josh being sent to the small Jersey town of Somerville to live with their biological father. This all played out when he was 13. While an experience like this sounds like hell on earth, well, he describes this as the point where he began to come out of his shell. He told me, "When I moved to Somerville, I wanted to make two things, friends and music. People always looked at me weird and never wanted to make friends with me. The fact that I wanted to make music made matters worse because people thought I was wasting my time. I guess I proved everyone wrong." Skinny credits his dad with helping him become a decent man along the way, expressing admiration for him and considering the man as his best friend. As for homegrown rappers who inspire him, well, Skinny admires Fetty Wap. Once Fetty broke onto the scene, well, Skinny was more confident in his ability to make it as an artist, being from a small town in New Jersey.
Skinny friendly. Skinny friendly.
I'll be real with you, Fetty Wap, when he arrived on the scene, it really was the beginning of the internet era. He did a lot of good stuff, especially for a man with one eye. Now, but while Skinny himself would eventually rise to prominence as a talented hip-hop star, living in Somerville was a challenge in his formative years. Commenting on his place amongst the townspeople, well, he stated, "Somerville is a small town where everyone knows each other. However, this would not help me make friends. I always felt like I was not white enough to hang with the white kids and not black enough to hang with the black kids. As a result, nobody wanted to hang out with me. I had a really hard time making friends. I was always looked at as the weird one. I was stuck in the middle." School also proved to be difficult. While Skinny remained a respectful student who performed well academically, he gradually began skipping class to focus on his music. He credits one particular teacher with supporting him. "I want to give a huge shout out to Miss O, who taught English at Somerville High. She knew what I wanted and always supported my dreams. She also told me to believe in myself, and that's exactly what I did." Attending Somerville High School, he was eventually held back a year due to his constant absence. He began working various jobs around town in order to support himself. These gigs included Wendy's, ShopRite, Red Lobster, and AMC Theaters. He actually considers AMC to be his favorite of the bunch. He also added that if he wasn't doing music, well, he'd probably be working a blue-collar job in a warehouse. I know what he means. Now, Skinny from the Nine, he attended Raritan Valley Community College in order to put his family at ease. But then he dropped out after a week. He later admitted that college life, well, it just wasn't for him. Now, his brother Josh was crucial in his career taking off. He believed in his brother's musical talents and would begin helping him to make music. As for his stage name, well, he got it from an ASAP Rocky track off the album Long Live ASAP. On the disc, there was a song entitled Pretty N-Word Rich, and loving the line, he changed his Instagram name to Skinny N-Word Rich. Now, the next day at school, kids were referring to him simply as Skinny, and in order to distinguish himself from other rappers with that nickname, well, he took the 9 from Somerville's 908 area code, and just like that, Skinny from the 9 was born.
So you can watch it. Every time you see me, I got bands in my pocket. Saying in my city, they just hate me because I'm popping. When I get that first check, everybody going shopping.
The hustle was real for young David, who was determined to become a name to remember in the rap game. In between working steady jobs to pay for his studio time, well, Skinny would hit the booth and record as often as he could.
Ready? Skinny! Louder, louder, louder! Skinny!
Around 2015, Skinny states that he paid to be on the lineup, opening for Joe Budden and Corey Guns in New Jersey. He states he doesn't regret the decision to pay for performing because, well, in the long run, it paid off. Now, we actually found the promo for what we think was the show he performed on, and for some reason, his name is not on the poster. But, well, hopefully this is it. They probably wanted more money for that. And he just needed to get on stage. Now, Skinny has said that the greatest turning point in his come up may be his girlfriend breaking up with him. Feeling hopeless and depressed, well, he decided to head to the studio and pour his pain into his music. What resulted was a song the rapper titled Love Blast. Uploading it to SoundCloud, the track became a viral smash, making it to the top of the site's charts by the very next day. He described having A&Rs contacting him from various labels, looking to sign him right then and there. Less than a week later, he settled a $5 million deal with none other than L.A. Reid.
I just want to say thank you to all my fans who wrote me, helped me down in there. I appreciate that shit.
Having signed that deal out in L.A., he then returned back to Jersey in mid-2018, and he pulled up to his high school parking lot in a Lamborghini, and he received quite the warm welcome home from students, as you can imagine. Look at Skinny now, what?
What's poppin'? What's poppin'? Yo!
Okay, we're gonna get into Skinny's recent arrest, but for now, it looks like it's getting a little smoky in here. You've all heard of candy pens, right? Well, if the name doesn't ring a bell, I got a good feeling you've seen them before. Candy pens was named best vaporizer of 2018 by High Times due to its combination of popular technology and flashy design. And candy pens, well, they've quickly become the go-to choice for vaping in the rap community. They've got co-signs from DJ Khaled, Fatboy SSC, Young M.A., Amber Rose, and A$AP Rocky. In fact, A$AP, he's got his own line called the Flacco Jody Collection, and Amber Rose, well, she has her own signature line. That's why she's looking awfully sexy in all them billboards. Oh, I'd like to have one of hers used. Now, candy pens, they're for those 18 years and older, and seeing as I'm the official YouTube ambassador, well, they gave me the ability to get you 25% off your entire order during checkout. That's right. There's a link down below, use the promo code BTWF25, and now let's get back to Skinny from the 9. In August of 2018, the rapper was arrested on charges of kidnapping and aggravated assault in his hometown. Now, he was actually just released from jail like a little over a week before we filmed this video. Now, during his 3-month incarceration, well, he talked about changing his perspective on life. While locked up, he would read the James Prince memoir as well as the Gucci Mane autobiography. Soaking up knowledge from these figures, well, it helped him to grow. And upon his release, he was ready to re-enter society a better and stronger person. Now, there was some controversy online after his release, with several sources claiming that the rapper had snitched on his accomplices in order to receive a lighter sentence, but he cleared this up pretty quickly.
Yo, I think it's so funny because I go on my Instagram and I see all these comments of everybody calling me a snitch. My 3 codees all came home. So if I would have snitched on anybody, nobody would be going home right now.
I don't know who did it. You know, they didn't see who did it. Did anybody say who did it? Talk about it?
No.
But you were in the house when that occurred, you said?
Yeah.
Okay.
Dave, if I give you a lie detector test right now, I hooked you up to the red box lie detector, asking you who shot the flare gun at the house in Bound Brook, and you said to me right now, I don't know who did it. Would you pass or fail?
Pass.
100%.
Skinny from the 9 is now awaiting the release of his debut project called It's an Evil World, out on November 30th, 2018. The effort includes guest appearances by P&B Rock, Cap G, as well as one of his personal heroes, good ol' Fetty Wap. Now he's certainly seeing the success that he had always dreamt of, and he has stated that he has also caught the attention of Black China. For real. He's had a crush on her ever since forever, and well, the two have apparently linked up. Good for you. Enjoy them perks of success, buddy. I'm jealous. As for the rest of the story, well, I guess we'll have to wait and see. Of course, this is before they're famous. My name is Michael McCredden. We make all sorts of celebrity bios here for you on this channel. Thanks again to Candy Pens. Be sure to check out their link. Thanks to Skinny from the 9 for helping us out, answering all our questions. Let us know who's next, and I'll see you guys in another video. Boom! Boom! They call me Chubby from the 6. What?